Hey, what's up guys? I'm Shantan. Anything in mathematics? Let's math magic. So as I told in the previous video, in the general equation of second degree, that we'll discuss in depth, in details about the various types of 2D connections. And so in this video, I'm going to discuss about the straight lines. So the general equation of straight line is given by ax plus by plus c equals to 0. That is a linear form. We find the linear form of x and y. That is, there is no second order of x or y. Okay, so now here the small a, small b and small c. These three terms are all constant terms. They can be positive or negative. And now there are various types of form of a straight line. That is a two-point form, one-point slope form, and any other form, that is normal form, symmetric form, intercept form. So we'll discuss in this video in details about that. Let's get started. What is the slope of a straight line? Actually, the slope of a straight line is it is denoted by small m, and small m equals to tan theta. Here this theta is an angle that is the straight line making with the positive direction of x-axis. There is another form, another way to find m. That is, if we have two points lying on that straight line, then we can find the slope of that straight line. Now, in various books about the questions about the straight line, the main question is that is to find the equation of the straight line. Now, how to find the equation of a straight line? There is many other ways to find the equation of a straight line of these different type of forms. So we have to first see that what type of data is given and that sum in that problem. Then we will evaluate the equation of the straight line by that method. That is, if there are two points is given on the straight line, lying on the straight line, and we have to find the equation of the straight line, then we use the two-point form. The formula is y minus y1 by x minus x1 equals to y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. That is, you can easily find that here, that right-hand side part is actually the slope of that straight line. So here it comes the second form, that is one-point slope form. That is, if one point of a straight line is given and the slope of the straight line is given, then we will find the equation of the straight line by the one-point slope form. That is, if one point is given, then let the one point be x1, y1 and the slope be small m. Then the equation will be y minus y1 equals to small m into x minus x1. This is the equation of the required straight line. And there is another form, that is the intercept form. That is, if we have the y-intercept and the slope of the straight line. That is, if the y-intercept is given and the slope of the straight line is given, then we can find the equation of the straight line by this formula. That is, y equals to mx plus c. Here small m is the slope of the straight line and c is the y-intercept of the straight line. This is very important formula of its important structure of the straight line, because if we have a general equation format of a straight line, then if we want to know the slope of the straight line, then we can format the, we can do some steps of that general form. Then we can find, we can do the structure, that is y equals to mx plus c. Then the coefficient of x, that is the m. This is the slope of the straight line. Then we can find the slope of the straight line. That if we want to know the slope of the straight line, we can do this method. And I think the most important formula of the straight line is x by a plus y by b equals to 1. That is the intercept form, because this intercept form is also used in various topics of mathematics. That is the linear programming problem. Talk about the other formats of the straight line. That is those formats, those structures, those formulas of the straight line is not frequently used. So that I didn't mention that about those in this video. The formats are the symmetric form, that is x minus x1 by cos theta equals to y minus y1 by sin theta equals to r. So this formula, you can derive this formula from the slope, one point slope form. That is, the one point slope form was y minus y1 equals to m into x minus x1. So here you put m equals to tan theta, and then you can, if you put in the place of tan theta, that is sin theta by cos theta, then after doing some steps you can find like this, that is, x minus x1 by cos theta equals to y minus y1 by sin theta. Now it's depend, the value of R is depending to the where the xy, the what the point xy is situated now. There is another form, that is the normal form. Formula of the normal form is x cos alpha plus y sin alpha equals to small p. Here the actually the form, the diagram is looks like this. There is a straight line, and you just draw a perpendicular from the origin to the straight line. Then the perpendicular is drawn. Now this is a straight line. The perpendicular is a straight line. So this straight line, that is the perpendicular making, perpendicular is making the alpha with the positive direction of x axis. The small p is actually the perpendicular distance, that is the length of the straight line from the origin. So if we know the perpendicular distance anytime, and we know the perpendicular is making a making an angle alpha with the positive direction of x axis, then you can choose this format to, we can use this formula, that is the normal form, to find the equation of a straight line. Two or three or more straight lines are concurrents. That is means what? That is if three or more straight lines are passing through a common point, then that straight lines, all the straight lines are called the concurrent straight lines. Now how we can determine that, how can we check that this all the straight lines are concurrent? Just we have to do the simple steps. That is, you can solve the first two straight lines. That is, you can solve the first two equation of the straight line, and you have already known that is the equation of the straight lines are nothing but the linear equation of two variables. So you have already learned that to solve the linear equation of two variables, that is you know the cross multiplication, you know the elimination, comparison and some substitutions. So you can solve the first two straight lines, and you could find the result, that is x equals to something and y equals to something. Then you just put the x value of the x and value of the y in the third. If the third equation is satisfied by this x and y, then the third equation is also passing through that point of intersection of the first two straight lines. Then all these three straight lines are concurrent. So this was the class. Guys, I hope that you have already understand something about the straight line. And have any queries, any questions regarding this class, let me know in the comment section below. And I will make another video about solving some mathematical problems on straight lines. So thanks guys for watching this video. Hope you will enjoy this video. And if you have any questions regarding this class, please comment down below. Thanks for watching. Jai Hind. Vande Mataram. Keep in touch.